In this video, we'll show you how to find trending video topics on YouTube for free. Hello, TubeBuddies. We wanted to show you how you can easily find trending video topics right from TubeBuddy's Keyword Explorer. Creating videos around a trend that is related to your channel is a great way to grow your audience and talk about something new on your channel. For example, if you're a gaming channel and there's a new game on the horizon, maybe you're a filmmaking channel and a brand new piece of gear is about to be released. Whatever the reason, there are ways to identify trends on YouTube. And here's how you can identify trends for free using TubeBuddy. To get started, click on the TubeBuddy drop-down menu, and under Extension Tools, click on Keyword Explorer. Here you'll see our keyword research tool, but under that, you'll see what's trending for your location. Since TubeBuddy is based in the United States, it shows the United States by default here. You can change which country you're in by clicking on it here and selecting where you're located. I'll select my good friend and coworker Rob's home country of Canada. As you can see, the trending results have changed. This is important because if your audience is mainly from your country or other countries, it's a good idea to know what people are interested about in that location. Since TubeBuddy is based in the United States, I'll switch back to the United States. There are two things you can do with trending topics. You can explore them with a Keyword Explorer by clicking on the green Explore button found here. Or you can open up this keyword in Google Trends, where we're getting this data from, by clicking here. A great strategy for trending topics comes from our friend Salma Jafri. Salma says that Evergreen plus trending equals a great combination. What?
Hey, Andrew, are you quoting me again?
Oh, hi, Salma. Yes, what you said about trending topics is great, and I know you have a lot of content on your channel about it.
Exactly, and you do know you could ask me about trends too, right? This is an area I have extensively covered.
Huh. You're right, Salma. You do have this covered. Thanks.
Wait, what?
I'm gonna go play Animal Crossing. You got this, Salma.
Wait, Andrew? Oh. Okay, well, what he was saying is true, because Evergreen plus trending topics is actually a great strategy to grow your YouTube channel and to get consistent views and traffic. In fact, let me show you a screenshot of the last, say, 20 or so videos that I've made. And you can see in these videos, there's a mix of evergreen and trending topics. So the trending topics, the first one is lockdown video ideas. Second one was a Zoom tutorial for beginners. And the third one was also related to Zoom going live on YouTube using Zoom, which I made earlier. But because it started trending, I linked it with the Zoom tutorial and that started to grow significantly as well. So when you go to Google Trends, you can see that lockdown videos is trending and it started trending around the same time that I made this video. And Zoom tutorial is also was a trending term when I made this video, right? So you can see that the growth came from those trending topics. But you can also see that there are evergreen topics in there which traditionally perform well for my channel. So for example, if you look in these last few videos that I've made, you can see that how to speak naturally to the camera, how to look good on camera, easy thumbnail ideas, these all have been proven to perform well on my channel and they bring me good consistent growth. So now let me take you further behind the scenes and show you the result of this strategy. So I'm gonna take you and show you three graphs, my views, watch time, and subscriber growth during the last 90 days when these videos were created. All right, so this is what I like to call the new normal, and I explain where that term comes from in just a second. So the first graph is the views graph. Now you can see that on average, I used to get 2,000 views per day, but after implementing this strategy, now my channel is getting 5,000 views per day. Similarly, for watch time, you can see it was 6,000 minutes per day, and now it's 15,000 minutes per day. And finally, for subscribers, you can see it was 30 subscribers a day, and now it's 90 to 100 subscribers per day. So the new normal is when you have a mix of evergreen and trending topics that actually elevates your channel, and the new normal becomes the new average for your channel as a result of this strategy. So you can see that the trending topics bring in the new subscribers and the surge in growth, while the evergreen topics, which are in your content library already, they are the ones that perform well for your core audience and they get you consistent growth and traffic. And so this strategy together forms the new normal, which is that the graph doesn't dip down, but a new baseline is established, which is higher than the older baseline of your video's performance. So the new baseline becomes the new normal for your channel as a result of this combination of trending and evergreen. Now, if you were to only focus on trending topics for your channel, then you might experience a lot of highs and lows because trends reach their maturity and then die, and then your channel would be very volatile in terms of growth. But on the flip side, if you only focus on evergreen content, then your channel might not experience these new surges and these new subscribers, and it would not be able to have those higher baselines. It might be stuck on that level and not have that surge. So how do you identify both trending topics and evergreen topics? So I'm gonna do that inside TubeBuddy. I'm gonna open up my laptop and walk you through that. All right, so let's say I run a tech channel and I've realized that Sony has come out with a new camera, and I do a search for Sony ZV-1. And what I'm gonna see right now, and I know this is a trending topic because look at this, top stories on CNN were 2 days ago, and there are very new videos out which were made 2 or 3 days ago by influencers who were probably given the camera, right? So this is an example of a trending topic. Now I wanna go inside TubeBuddy. So I'm going to go to my YouTube channel and click on my TubeBuddy button here. And then I'm gonna go into Keyword Explorer, launch the keyword, and type in the keyword that I've identified as possibly trending. And as I'm typing it, you can see that it's giving me options. So you can see that as I'm typing, the autocorrect is suggesting. So you can see that it's saying that this is a video that you should probably look at, or a keyword you should probably look at. So I'm gonna click on Sony ZV-1. And then you can see that it is good, but I'm gonna go to unweighted just to give you a more balanced perspective so it's not influenced by my channel. All right, so what I'm gonna do next is to go to the historical tab and see if this term is actually trending. And you can see that worldwide in the past 12 months on YouTube, those are the search filters, you can see that this term is actually trending. And this data is taken directly from Google Trends. In fact, if I were to go to Google Trends and do this exact same search, I just wanna show you, it's gonna look exactly the same. So this trends data is integrated into TubeBuddy. So if I were to type in ZV1 here and use the same search parameters. So let's make this worldwide, past 12 months, and YouTube. Then you'd see the exact same graph here and the exact same graph here, right? So that is one way of identifying inside TubeBuddy what search term is trending. So the next thing you want to do is identify a search term that you could possibly make a video around. So Sony ZV-1 is rated fair inside TubeBuddy. So I want to look for a term that would give me at least a good or a very good rating, or perhaps an excellent one. So if I do camera, it's still fair. So I'm going to go back here. So you can use TubeBuddy's related search feature here and find a keyword that you can actually rank for. Then that gives me a rating of a good. So that could be a possible video to create if I were a camera channel, a tech channel, a review channel, an unboxing channel, or a channel with comparisons of different cameras, right? So you wanna play around with this TubeBuddy feature and also go into web searches and video topics to perhaps find more ideas and more related ideas. So your key term is the Sony ZV-1, and then these are all the ideas that TubeBuddy is suggesting. So I'm gonna go into all of these and see which one could you have a better overall score and ranking for. So as you're looking at the graph of a trending topic, the time to make a video on a trending topic is right at this point, just as the trend is taking off. Now, when you're looking for evergreen topics, you're applying the same strategy, except in this case, you're looking for high search volume and low competition. So let me tell you what I mean by that. So let's go to a search term that I would typically rank well for, which is speak naturally in YouTube videos, right? So that's something that is a very good fit for my channel. And as you can see, I would rank very good for this particular keyword because YouTube knows that my core audience would love this, and because I already have similar videos out on my channel. So I have a very good chance of ranking for this keyword. So for evergreen, you're looking for high search volume, low competition, and stuff that your channel historically ranks well for, which would appeal to your core audience. So you might be thinking, well, how many videos should you create on trending topics and how many on evergreen? Well, I like to invoke the 80-20 principle in this, which states that 80% of your results are gonna come from 20% of your videos, which is really true on YouTube. So I think that if you're planning out the next 10 videos, focus on making 8 videos on evergreen topics that you know your core audience will love, and focus on 2 trending topics for your channel. The 2 trending topics are going to help your channel surge up and bring in new subscribers, while the evergreen topics are going to have consistent growth and form a new baseline for your channel. And if you're looking for more information on trending topics, there's a bunch on my YouTube channel. Just search for Salma Jafri trending topics and you'll be able to find all of those videos for more in-depth analysis. Thank you so much, Andrew and TubeBuddy, for having me on your channel. And now it's back to you, Andrew.
Why does fishing have to be... Thank you, Salma. That's awesome. What Salma said is awesome, and we highly recommend you check out her channel. Trending topics are a great way to help you earn more views on YouTube, and if planned accordingly, it can give you a chance to grow by giving you the opportunity to jump on a trend and get more views. Do you want to learn how to use TubeBuddy's Keyword Explorer to the fullest and help you earn more views? Check out that playlist on screen now to learn how to use it. Be sure to subscribe and ring the bell notification for TubeBuddy and Salma Jafri's YouTube channel for more YouTube tips and tricks. I'm Andrew Cam from TubeBuddy. Now go out and start looking for trending topics that you can cover.